So what is design? This is really, really important. Because you know everybody wants UI and UX and you know all this fancy stuff. But do you know what is design? Anybody wants to take a shot at this? Designers especially? So design, very interestingly, is rendering intent. Is rendering your intent. So as app designers and as product people, product managers, people who are conceptualizing products, organizations need to understand that it's that the designer will only render your intent. Now if your intent is not clear, then he'll render his intent, which is a problem, right? Because there's passion, the compassion and the passion that you have for your product as innovators is not going to come out to that designer. Poor guy is going to render, or poor girl is going to render your intent. He's not going to render your intent, but his intent or her intent, and that intent will be completely different. So let us focus on intent today. I mean, we need to get this. Intent has extreme power in it, okay? I'm telling you, and don't tell this to anybody, with intent you can change the molecular structure of things, right? So in front of you there's a glass, you can change it. You can walk through that wall. So holding that intent is extremely important. Extremely. So what is intent? And let me try and bring this out a little more in detail so that we don't get confused, because then we're moving to a very interesting part of the session. So intent. Now these two pens and objects have been designed with the intent. Anybody can guess the intent of both of these?
Writing.
Writing for sure, man. If it doesn't write, it doesn't work. Okay? But if you're in a session like this, you're going to use something like that. Right? For quick notes. You're not going to take out that hobbyist or that beautiful, you know, fountain pen, ink pen, and try and write something. Today it's not going to work, right? You use this when you're going to sign an important document, a big deed, when you're going to sign something, when you're getting married, you're going to sign up there and say, that's all over for me now. So it's designed. It's designed. This is designed. The function is extremely important because it renders the intent absolutely clear. One more thing. This is what apps do. There's a butter knife and there's a hunting knife. One is for butter, the other is for hunting. Don't get confused here, okay? Because a lot of people are actually building butter knives. They actually want to build butter knives, but they look at the hunting knife and say, wow, that looks too good here. That looks really great. So let's go and build hunting knives. Obviously, very clear, you can't go to the jungle with a butter knife and you can't turn up on your morning table with a hunting knife. You're going to look extremely silly. So please think about it. It's really, really important that we know what we are building. It's butter, let's say it's butter and go for it. Let's use credit cards and then talk about wallets and things like that. We don't even want to mention it. So clear, let's not over-articulate our offerings. We find it great, but our users might not find it great at all. So intent needs to be articulated beautifully. So I'm just summarizing very quickly. So big picture was about the clarity. From the clarity, we've got the intent, the truth behind the purpose, that we are going to do certain things. Let's be very, very, very clear on what it is. Write it down in one line. Write your intent down in one line. That's what we do with our clients. If you're able to write that intent down in one line, we can start moving to the process of design. Otherwise, we stop. We don't move forward. So all teams today, write your intent down in one line. Don't write a paragraph. You cannot write intent in a paragraph. It has to be one line, about 10 words. Don't try and do paragraphs and say, okay, this is my intent, one paragraph. I want, like, you look kind of like Google. Now we're moving on to design, and I'm going to touch on a very, very important subject. It's called emotional quotient. It works in our labs, it's our heart. Usually we don't bring this out into public view, but today we are exposing our EQ, our proprietary storing. And it's very, very deep, so try and hold this, hold your tension with me. So moving on to design. And while we are designers, remember, we are designing for emotions. That's what we do. Data influences us, very good data, but the heart of it all is emotions. If you talk to anybody who's designing great stuff, talk to Nest, talk to Apple, talk to Tesla, they all have got this right. They've got emotions, right? They understand emotions. In this country, we are very emotional people, but we don't understand emotions. We're emotional people because we cry and we, you know, do all sorts of stuff and make all sorts of noises. But when it comes to design, when it comes to product, we don't think emotions are important. So let me explain to you this emotion bit. What are emotions? I just want to bring this up. I've listed, there are about 27 emotions. You can play with, I've just put a few up here. Fear, anger, sadness, joy, disgust, trust, anticipation, surprise.
Actually, from usability PowerPoint, I found like one of the home button is helping me to go to the home page from anywhere. And the company is saying like it's not as per Android standards. So there is kind of a conflict, and then we need to resolve. And I'm ready to take the risk. I told like yes, put it, whatever it happens, put it.
You took the risk, huh?
Yeah. So that is fine, right? I would say like even.
See, listen, know. That judgment shouldn't come because I feel and my company feels.
Yeah.
That there are two egos talking to each other.
Okay.
I and company. There's something called user. Okay, if your user feels, if you know from your heart and from your research, and my user likes it, yes. You are not the user. Your company is not the user.